So I found another pretty funny fun fact of the day. It says, "Hop to it." The iconic rabbit, which is a vibrator if you don't know, is renowned for two things: excellent orgasm results and an odd smiley face on its tip. Woman's Health tells us that the smiley face was actually a result of conservative Japanese customs. Apparently, Japanese consumers frown upon the production of sex toys that too closely resembles phalluses. So the smiley face was added. If you don't know what a phallus is, it's actually the shaft of a male's penis. But, so yeah, guys, that's pretty interesting. Speaking of interesting, the story that I'm going to be talking about is pretty interesting. Actually, I'm going to be talking about this time when I actually peed on this random guy in a, bathroom. He was at a urinal and I peed on him. And, you guys are thinking, like, what the fuck are you talking about, Taylor? And, you know, that's the right reaction to be having. I was in shock for a while, I'm not gonna lie. Basically what happened is, let's go back about 4 years, so I'm 12 years old, and you know, I'm still at that immature phase where anything that has to do with penises is funny, you know, so my friend and I had a very close-knit relationship. We had known each other since preschool, and we had always been together, like, messing around. Not, okay guys, you are gonna be taking this way in the sexual way. No, we were not like that. No, we were always messing around, you know, like, having fun, playing outside, and then we'd come inside, play some Yu-Gi-Oh cards, then play some Pokemon, and then we'd play some video games, and we'd go skateboarding and ride our bikes, you know, that kind of messing around. Not in a sexual way. Come on, we were 12. We didn't even know what that was yet. So, being the best friends that we were, we decided one day to go to a baseball game after my dad offered to take us. It was a Red Sox versus Angels game at Angel Stadium because I live in Southern California, and I'm a huge Red Sox fan, so is my dad. So we all went to this game, and you know, the Red Sox were losing, but we were kids, we didn't really care at all, and you know, I'm a pretty big Red Sox fan now, but at the time, I really didn't care at all. But that's not the point. Basically, what happened is my friend had to go to the restroom. And since we were that age, we were 12 years old, you know, your parents were always like, oh, go to the restroom with your friends. There's going to be rapists in the bathroom and they're going to penetrate you with their penis and phalluses. And it's just like, really? Come on. But anyways, you know, I obeyed my parents' directions and I went to the restroom with my friend. And there were actually four urinals open, and there were two of them next to each other along the wall. And I took the one that was right next to the wall, and my friend took the one that was right next to me. And so, you know, I'm just sitting there kind of staring at the wall in front of me, doing my do. And all of a sudden, I feel this warm sensation running down my leg. And I look over, and my friend is giggling, if you could call it that. He's laughing, actually, pretty hard. And I look and he's peeing on my leg and I'm thinking to myself, what the hell are you doing? So of course I freak out. I push him against the wall. I'm like, what the hell was that for? Because obviously I didn't know what that word meant back in that age. But, you know, I tell him, I was like, what the hell was that for? And, you know, we end up just leaving the bathroom. I'm kind of mad at him for a while, but eventually I get over it, wash my leg off, obviously. And then later on in the year, actually about 3 to 4 months later, I pretty much thought that he was going to forget about it, which he ended up doing. He completely forgot about what he had done, and I was planning the perfect time to get back at him. About 3 or 4 months later in the year, we went to another sporting event. This time it was a high school sporting event. It was actually the one city against another. And we ended up, you know, going to it, and he had to go to the restroom again. And so I waited about 30 seconds after he went into the restroom, and then I followed him to kind of sneak up on him and pee on him, being the immature little kid that I was. And so I walked into the restroom following him, and I saw what appeared to be his shirt and shorts peeing against a urinal. But what I didn't know is he had actually gone into the toilets and to take a dump. And so I see this guy that looks about the same height, he's got kind of the same hair color, and I wasn't really paying attention, I just sneak up quickly, yank out my wang, and start peeing on him, and the guy turns around, and I see who he really is, and I'm like, oh my god, I am so sorry. I quickly zip up and bolt out of there, and luckily I got away before he could find out which way I went, so nothing actually happened out of that incident. I told my friend and he started laughing, and you know, that's probably the correct response. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed. 100 likes and I'll release my next story. Peace.